Installing an asphalt driveway properly can mean the difference between a driveway that will last just a few years and a driveway that can last up to 20 or even 30 years. We only get one chance to get the job done right. Whether you're removing and replacing an existing asphalt driveway or having a brand new one installed, the process is the same. Hi, I'm Patrick Mattingly, the founder of AllAboutDriveways.com. I have well over a decade of experience in the driveway business. During that time, I've looked at literally thousands upon thousands of driveways. For the most part, I've seen the most beautiful driveways, driveways that look just as good as they did when they were first installed 15 to 20 years ago. On the other hand, I've seen some of the worst work you could ever imagine. Homeowners from all over the country who've contacted us and filed complaints and sent us pictures of some of the worst driveways I've ever seen. Driveways that last just a few months to maybe a year. Homeowners who've lost several $1,000. Don't waste your hard-earned money on an inexperienced or fly-by-night contractor. Here's how to install an asphalt driveway the right way. First is the preparation of the subgrade. Proper subgrade preparation is extremely important for a driveway that will last a lifetime. The better the subgrade preparation, the better the driveway. Now, the most important aspect of the grading process is the drainage planning. The soil should be excavated and fine-graded for proper water drainage. We want to make sure that two things happen here. One, the water runs away from the garage or away from the house to avoid flooding. And two, we also want to make sure that the water runs off of the asphalt. We want to avoid water pooling and sitting on the surface of the asphalt to avoid pavement failures and premature deterioration. Material like rocks or gravel should be removed prior to grading and paving the driveway. A good rule of thumb is anything that moves beneath our feet should not be paved on and should be removed from the driveway prior to installing the asphalt. Now, if the driveway consists of any soft or unstable material like clay, sand, or topsoil, this should also be removed, and a strong base material like road base, recycled concrete, or limestone, just to name a few, should be installed prior to installing the new hot asphalt. This will help stabilize the subgrade and make the driveway much stronger and much more durable. Now, when it comes to long driveways, contrary to popular belief, long driveways should not be graded with a crown in them. Long driveways should be graded flat, but with a slight pitch to either side to get the water to run off of the surface of the asphalt. There is absolutely no advantage to installing a driveway with a crown in it. As a matter of fact, crowning can actually cause premature deterioration and pavement failure. Crowning long driveways is also a very common way for asphalt contractors to rip homeowners off, so avoid crowns at all costs. Once the grading is complete, the subgrade should then be compacted with the rollers before installing the asphalt. Next, an herbicide should be put down to minimize vegetation growth. Weeds growing up through the asphalt can cause irreparable damage and eventually pavement failure. So a quality herbicide should be put down prior to installing the asphalt. Now we're ready to begin laying the asphalt. Now the asphalt should be installed using an asphalt paving machine and not by hand. This is going to provide a consistent average depth of asphalt throughout the driveway and a much smoother finish to the surface. Some areas that are too small for the equipment to get to will need to be installed by hand, which can slightly add to the overall cost. Experienced asphalt rakers are also an integral part of a nicely finished surface. Now, when the asphalt is being laid out of the paving machine, it's not compacted yet. Therefore, it needs to be compacted. This is where hiring an experienced contractor is very important. The asphalt should be compacted soon after it's laid out of the paving machine while it's still hot. If the asphalt cools down too much before rolling it, it's not going to get compacted well enough. Too little compaction will allow water to penetrate the asphalt and cause it to deteriorate much faster, cutting the life expectancy dramatically. On the other hand, too much compaction while it's still hot can cause the asphalt to stretch and crack, causing premature pavement failures. Now here's probably the most important aspect of a new asphalt driveway, and that's the thickness. The thickness is going to determine whether the driveway lasts just a few months or whether it lasts 20 to 30 years like it should. But there's some dirty little secrets that contractors don't want you to know about. They've learned how to increase their profits and line their pockets with your hard-earned money, and you won't even realize it until they're long gone, 3 months, 6 months, or a year down the road, and you can't get a hold of them for them to honor their warranty. When this video is finished, go to our website and watch or read our ebook on our series, The Most Common Ways Asphalt Installation Contractors Rip Us Off and How to Avoid Them. There, we're going to reveal all of their dirty little secrets so that when you're getting estimates, you can choose the right contractor and you know what questions to ask and you know how to avoid the bad guys. Some contractors may also offer to install a driveway in two lifts. What this means is they'll install one layer of asphalt, compact it, then start at the beginning of the driveway again and install a second layer of asphalt and compact that layer. Now, this is not a requirement, and in most cases is really overkill for a residential driveway, but it makes for a much more durable driveway, a much smoother ride, and a more beautifully finished surface. Now, it does cost more money since there is more time, labor, and materials required, so be prepared to pay additional costs for a driveway that's installed in two lifts. Compacting the edges will help strengthen them and make them less prone to cracking and deterioration. During the grading process, some of the subgrade material should be left along the edges so that once the driveway is complete, that material can be pulled up to the edge of the asphalt. This gives the driveway the appearance of sitting down in the soil rather than just being laid out on top, leaving the edges exposed. This will also help create a nice strong shoulder to transition from the asphalt to help minimize cracking in the event that a vehicle drives off of the edge. Gravel that was removed during the grading process can also be used to edge or shoulder the driveway. Once the asphalt installation is complete, caution tape or cones should be put up at the end of the driveway to keep people from driving on it until it's completely cooled down. And that's how to pave an asphalt driveway the right way. And with proper maintenance and upkeep, an asphalt driveway will last between 20 or even 30 years. If you're looking for a new asphalt driveway, make sure you visit our website at allaboutdriveways.com and request a free estimate from our background-checked, pre-screened professional contractors. There, you're not going to find just any contractor. You're going to find the best contractors, contractors that we've checked out and we know you can trust. Or you can call us at 866-966-9939. That's 866-966-9939. 9939 and request a free estimate from one of our top contractors, just like the one that you've seen here. Thanks for watching and good luck with your new asphalt driveway.